Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this video, we're gonna look at using Illustrator for web and UI app design. Now, Illustrator is one of the tools that gets used a lot by UI and UX designers to build things like websites and apps. Now, we're not gonna go through everything possible for web and UI for Illustrator. I've got a completely other course that's dedicated to it. Like it's another 50 videos. So if you wanna go and like full bore do it, go check out that course. You're looking for that little smiley man icon, okay? So it's the web and UI design in Illustrator. But this is the advanced course and I didn't want to kind of leave you hanging. So I'm going to give you the kind of the high level stuff that you'll need to know. The first one is exporting these graphics that you've created for a website or an app. So we're going to work on the mobile version first. Okay, and what I'd like to do is, let's say we've drawn this like a little tick in the circle. I want to export that for my website. So there's a couple of ways. So I'm going to ungroup this first, okay, because I don't want the text. I want these two. So I'm gonna zoom in, I go U. Cool, so I've got both of them selected. They're not grouped. I can right click them and go to export, click for export as a single asset or multiple assets. Let's do multiple assets first and just see what it does. So it's opened up my export panel, which has already got a Kiwi in there. Hello, goodbye. There's the circle and the tick separately. Okay, so what I might do is I might undo that, Kiwi comes back, is right click and say export for single asset. Or like what I tend to do is, let's say this logo at the top here, I just drag it in, okay? And if you drag it in while it's grouped, it will kind of do a single asset. If it's ungrouped, and I drag it in, it does that kind of multiple assets. Depends on what you need. And the next thing is I'm gonna select on this asset here, I'm gonna give it a name. It's important, not important, but if you give it a name now, when we export it, this is the name it's gonna get. So let's call this my tick. Okay, and down the bottom here, you get to decide on the format. Now, when you're exporting for web, there's three main formats, JPEG, PNG, and SVG. Now, basically, JPEGs are good for images, PNGs are good for things that have transparency, and SVGs are new and fancy and vector. Okay, it's scalable vector graphic is the acronym, and they're getting more and more popular. When I'm building a website as a web designer, I'll use SVGs wherever I can because they scale nicely. They look great on all screens. But talk to your web designer or web developer for what they need. Some websites have to support older browsers and SVGs don't work. So as a safe bet, you can do both. So what you do is, I want a PNG, I want to add, don't think add scale, think add version. Okay, so this has made a bigger size for me. I don't want a bigger size, I just want to go to SVG. So I've got two options here. Now, this is kind of for web design. If I wanted to go for app design, the easiest way is to click on this guy and say I'm going for iOS, which is your iPhone, or Android, which is pretty much everything else. So I click on that, it's gonna give me, this is what my app designer or app developer wants. Okay, they want a small size, the regular size, and a bunch of other different scales. Okay, so it goes up and down. So that's just done for you. Can I undo? I can't. I'm gonna have to click them all off. So let's say we're going for web design. So I've got add scale. I'm gonna not add a suffix. I'm just gonna make this one one. And this guy down here, SVG. This is a kind of really common kind of grouping to send out. But again, talk to your web developer. Now, once you've got it, you click on export and give it a folder. I'm just gonna lump mine on the desktop, click choose. We're gonna go check on the desktop. And I've got this junk from when I was practicing, and there's the Kiwi. So I've got my tick, which is my PNG, and my SVG. Cool, huh? And yeah, so that's how to export just single graphics. And you'll do that a lot. The ticks will get built in HTML and CSS. If you are interested in this kind of thing, I've got quite a few Dreamweaver courses for building websites. Okay, if you wanna get into a bit of HTML and CSS, go do that one. Now, one thing you might notice is, if you are a big fan of using clipping masks, it had something pre-made, but I've got a blob, okay? And it's got no fill. Okay, let's go give them a fill. And I want to crop it down to, say, this size for some reason. I'm gonna hold down Command-7 or Control-7 on a PC. Okay, so I've cropped it down. The problem is, when I drag it into my assets panel, can you see it's got my graphic there? It's a little hard to see, you might have to zoom in. There we go. But it's actually got this kind of, can you see all the stuff around the outside here? It's actually included in the thing. So it's not gonna be a nice trimmed box. It's gonna have a junk around the outside. So what you need to do is, with it selected, actually before you do it, okay, before you kind of clipping mask or right click and release the clipping mask, select it. I like to use my shape builder tool, which is Shift M. Okay, there he is there. And I'm just gonna delete this stuff off. It's a better kind of way of preparing graphics, because now that thing there, if I drag it in, it's actually all the way to the edges. Okay, and there's a little bit of gap at the top, don't worry. For some reason, they really like to show a square, but that's all trimmed up now. Now that happens as well with images. Okay, so you do a lot of cropping of images in Illustrator. So I'm gonna bring in an image, just random one from my exercise files. Okay, and let's say I wanna crop this down to a circle. And I do a tiny circle around his head. Okay, and I crop it. It's the same principle here. If I drag it in, it's made this big graphic with this little circle in the middle. The outside is transparent and that might be okay for you, but what you need to do is, with this guy selected, what you need to do is, I'm gonna release the clipping mask again, okay, and I'm gonna select on this guy, and there's one that says crop image, okay, and I can drag it so it should snap. If it's not snapping to the edges, go to view smart guides and turn those on. Okay, so get it kind of where you want it first, hit return. And the cool thing about that is cropped. There's like pixels are gone. It's like Photoshop cropping. Okay, so it's a cool new feature in Illustrator. Now I get to make my mask, drag it in, and it should be an entire circle. Cool, give it a name. And in this case, we'll shave that one out probably as a JPEG. Another interesting thing to know is that this guy over here has been added. So we're gonna call him Blob. Okay, and this guy's been added and he is Man. Great SEO, Dan. What ends up happening here is that it's not a one-way street, right? So this guy, if I update him and give him a different fill color, you'll notice that he updates up here. Okay, so that's true of all these graphics. So you can kind of name them, spend some time, work out what kind of versioning you want. Okay, so I want to select all of these guys, hold shift and click them all, and I want PNGs, want some JPEGs, and I want some SVG goodness. And if I hit export, let's select them all again. It'll only export the ones you have selected. Okay, click on export, back in the same place. It'll override the ones you already have, which is cool. Okay, so my blob now, there's two versions, JPEG, PNG, and SVG. Okay, but if I go and quickly update this, okay, the designer comes back and says it's not working, or you're the web developer and you're like, I don't like it. Come back into here, and I just click on this one guy, click export, and he'll go back out now, replace all those fellas. It's a nice, cool, like little system they got going. Good work, Adobe. Next thing is, so we've got the graphics out, but the text doesn't want to be included in as graphics, okay? Your web designer doesn't want the actual like graphic of the text, they want the actual text and the styles that you've used. Okay, so you could obviously go in here and tell them it was Open Sans and it was 14, but they wanna know all sorts of things about it. And yeah, that can be problematic unless you go to Window and go to CSS Properties. Okay, and the cool thing about it is, especially text is easy, you can see it tells you this is the CSS for it if you've not used it before. Okay, that's the code that says I am Open Sans, I'm bold, these are the colors. So super handy, you can just copy and paste that and send them and say, this title is this. You can get super fancy and start naming character styles, okay, and it'll give you classes. Often I just copy and paste this as I'm building. Now you can do it for text is really easy, you just click on it and you can see this is Playfair bold and it's all the code. Now let's say this kind of red box in the background here, say I wanted to export this as a graphic. I probably wouldn't, I'd build that in CSS, but anyway, let's say you did. And it says there's no code generated because there's no name for it, it needs a name. You do it in your layers panel. Okay, so twirl this down, it should show me in here, see the blue dot? That blue dot indicates that's the thing you've got selected. If I double click it, okay, and give it a name and call this one red underscore box. When you're naming things like this in web design, okay, it's often hyphens, no spaces, hyphens or underscores. And you can see now with it selected, it says my class of red box has got a background color of this. Okay, so there's just some really cool stuff. If you want to get a bit more hardcore into it, you can go into the burger menus, go to export options. At the moment, it's only telling me the basics, and that's what I want. Yours might be on by default. I can't remember if I've turned this on or off or not, but you could include the dimensions and the absolute positioning. Okay, so click OK, and it's giving me how far it is from the top and left. There was another option in there. Let's have a look, export options. Generate CSS for unnamed objects. Instead of having to go name them, to be all official, just tick that on and it'll let you create CSS for everything without having to go and name them. All right. Next thing to know is we're going to go something called pixel preview. So I've generated down the bottom left of this desktop version. Let's go down here to him. Let's close down my CSS properties. And let's talk about pixels, because in Illustrator, right, it's a vector drawing program. So it scales, everything looks super sharp on the edges. But when I go to images in web design, often JPEGs or PNGs, they use pixels, okay? And pixels not as, you know, not as sharp around the edges. So what we need to do is, before we say I need this to be a PNG, I need to preview it in pixel preview. So view pixel preview. Because what you'll find is a lot of graphics will end up looking really good in Illustrator, but then you export the PNG and they're kind of fuzzy on the sides or one side, and you're like, meh. Okay, so what you can do is you can turn that on, first of all, and it shows you what this would look like if it was pixels. Okay, so you can see my lines, let's turn that on and off. Cool. And so there's a couple of things you can do. Let's say this line here, and I'm gonna turn on my pixel preview again. It's not looking great. Okay, because it's kind of, the problem is the stroke is not, is it 1 point? I'm not sure. It is 1 point, which is cool, but it's kind of straddling 2 pixels here. So what you can do is you can right click it and say, my friend, make pixel perfect. Okay, so it just kind of adjusts it. Now it has moved, like literally has moved, but for me, that's better than having it fuzzy. So you can decide. And this guy here, same thing, you make pixel perfect. Everything will just kind of tidy up. That box is a slightly different size. Text is a little harder, right? Adjusting type can really, it depends on how precious you are with type, and like especially small type, it changes it quite a bit, because you can see that. It's actually quite, like things have happened to that font. Depends on if you can live with that or not. You can see that top one is a little bit higher. So yeah, big fonts you won't notice, smaller fonts you might. So be careful there. The other thing you can do is, if you know you're just going for web design, just draw stuff that you can see view, and there's one called snap to pixel. Make sure that's on, okay? Because what happens is with it off, I can draw something and like a rectangle here, and it will just kind of appear wherever it likes. Whereas if I do the exact same thing and say snap to pixel and draw him, he will, you know, try and be in the right spot. Now this works for simple shapes like this. Really complex shapes, it just kind of doesn't know what to do. It's rounded corners, everything's rounded. If I go make pixel perfect, it kind of worked, but sometimes it just, messes up. It's really easy for lines and squares, but really complex shapes, not so good. Okay, I'm gonna turn off my pixel preview, and let's look at two more things. Okay, one is exporting, actually no, it's symbols. Let's say that, as good as you guys were, you can hang out up here, I need to make, when you're doing UI design, in this course, we just kind of made a desktop, tablet, and mobile, but when I'm doing mobile, you'll end up creating 50 mobile like mockups, okay, of all the different pages or an app. Okay, you might have 100 different app screens. What you don't want to do is, let's say I duplicate this, right? So I'm going to grab my artboard tool, hold Alt while I'm dragging. So I've got another version, right? And if I make adjustments to this, and this is now the contact us page, the problem is if I adjust this heading now, I'm going to have to go back and copy and paste it on every page. So what you do, once you kind of got like a base level going, you're going to create a symbol. Okay, so I'm going to select all of this, and I'm going to go to Window, go down to Symbols, and I'm going to make a symbol by clicking the little turned up page. I'm gonna give it a name. This is gonna be my mobile nav UI. Okay, click okay. And nothing really changes. It's kind of like a group now, but what ends up happening is I'm gonna close down my symbols library. I'm going to zoom out, grab my artboard tool, make a duplicate. And now what's gonna happen is, let's say client comes back and says, actually, there's been some usability problems with the size of this font, right? So I've double clicked it with my black arrow, and it says, be careful, you're editing a symbol. I'm like, awesome, I know. And I'm gonna ungroup these, and I just want this guy. So you, my friend, now is going to be something else, like Open Sans extra bold, okay? And I'm gonna click this arrow until I get back out. And what you'll notice is, ta-da, he updates. Okay, so great for navs and like footers, anything that's kind of consistent on your website, logos, that type of thing. All right, nearly finished. The last thing that's kind of useful is, let's say I've got this and I want to send it to the client to proof, or I want to add some interactivity, maybe with something like XD or Envision, which kind of allows you to add interactivity to things like JPEGs. So what we're going to do is we're going to export the screen. So file, go down to export, and they call it screens. Okay, so all the different screen sizes and not assets. Okay, you can kind of do it from here as well, but under artboards, I can say I want all of these guys exported. What I want them exported as, I want them exported as JPEGs at 80%. Okay, so you can fiddle around with what you want to do, but yeah, export that and either just, or maybe down here there's a PDF option that could be quite helpful because then it's a multi-page PDF. Or if you want to add interactivity in XD or InVision, you can export maybe JPEGs to send it up. All right, friends, that is the skinny version of being a UI web designer with Illustrator. Know that there's a lot more you could do. Okay, so check out that course if you're keen. Otherwise, let's get on to the next video. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I want to see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something. Don't be shy. I'd love to see what it is. If you're if you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, for you to mention me. I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram. And on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.